So, hi ladies, it's your girl Angel, 515-2010, and today is going to be, yes, you guys are reading that right, my 24-week pregnancy update. This is actually going to be a combination of 23 and 24-week pregnancy update, only because not much happened in week 23. And I had a doctor's appointment right at the start of my 24th week, so I kind of wanted to wait and combine the two together. As of right now, baby is the size of an ear cone, which is really fitting because it's Thanksgiving week and, you know, it's important on Thanksgiving. Nathaniel is 12.5 inches long and about 1.25 pounds. These are just estimates based on the app that I use, so they're not, you know, extremely accurate. So let's get right into it. This week I went to the doctor on week 24, I went Thursday. It was Thursday of last week, but that's when I turned 24 weeks. They did start to measure my belly. My belly was measuring at 25 centimeters. My doctor told me that that was appropriate for, you know, how far along I am. I have gained one additional pound on top of the one that I gained last week. So I'm down a total of 4 pounds for the pregnancy. I was down 6 at the beginning and then I gained back the 2 now. So I'm -4 for this pregnancy. He didn't mention anything about me needing to gain more weight. He said he was very pleased with my weight gain. I'm guessing because I'm only gaining a pound every 4 weeks. So I'm guessing that's good. He said baby's measuring fine, but he wouldn't be too concerned about it. So I'm not really concerned about the weight gain either. Some concerns that I had addressed with him is my calcium intake. I don't like milk. I don't. I switched to almond milk, which doesn't have as much protein as regular milk. So I was trying to switch back just to get more protein and calcium for baby. I did switch brands. I switched to the Fairlife brand. It's really, really good compared to just regular plain old milk. So if you guys aren't using Fairlife or haven't tried it, I suggest trying it. It's worth the extra money that you pay. Plus, they keep longer. Like, I don't drink milk a lot, and the hub doesn't drink milk a lot. So buying a half gallon of 2% milk for us, the milk always goes bad before we can finish the thing. When we buy a Fairlife container, it lasts about a month and a half before the expiration date. So that's really good. But once again, I still wasn't drinking a glass a day. So he recommended that I get some calcium pills. He recommended between 250 and 300 milligrams twice a day. So for a total of 600 milligrams per day. And he recommended that it had vitamin D3 in it. So I went to Target and I ended up getting the 600 milligrams plus the D3 vitamin. I got the family size for like 600 pills for I think $13, and I had a cartwheel for it, so it dropped down to like 10. But I put the pill on half in the morning. I'll take half in the morning and then I'll take half at night. He recommended doing it in 2 doses instead of just taking the whole 600 pills. All at once, he said, because your body absorbs the calcium better when it takes it in, broken down in the stages. So I just do not interested because I do half a pill in the morning and then half a pill in the evening, as well as I'm still doing my prenatal vitamin with the DHA in it. So I've added the calcium supplement and the only thing. So I'm guessing if you ladies don't think that you're getting enough calcium during your pregnancy, I would suggest talking to your doctor because you can't do a supplement like he recommended for me. Nathaniel is getting really active. He likes to be active in the morning around maybe 9 or 10, and then he'll be active around 7:30, 8 o'clock at night. And that's a lot of time that I get off work and I get home and see the hug, and he knows the hug's voice. He knows when he touches my stomach. Every night, my husband reads him a story, so he loves his story time with Dad at night. And he just goes to my husband, you know, face up in my belly and just talks to him, but just starts kicking like crazy. His movements are getting a lot stronger. I actually felt some punches on top of the kick at the top part of my stomach, so I'm glad he's getting a lot bigger, a lot stronger, just trying to run out of space in there. so far as cravings, I haven't had any weird cravings that have came on since, you know, the pregnancy. I have started to want a snack a little bit later at night, so about 11:30, I'll try to eat, a peanut butter sandwich or something just to kind of hold me over until the morning. I didn't eat one last night, so at about, I'd say, 5:30, 6 o'clock this morning, I, like, popped him out of bed because he was, like, keeping me up crazy. Like, he wouldn't get up and eat something. So I got up to fix the peanut butter sandwich at, like, 6 o'clock this morning. So I'm guessing he wants more, or, you know, he's trying to tell me to eat more. So I'm going to start doing that. I'm starting to snack right before bed. I'm going to try to do not too bad, but something. Peanut butter is a protein, so I figured I'd still can. I can do it in the middle of the night, but hey. Let's see, what else can I tell you, ladies? My stomach has started to get bigger. My belly button is starting to become an alley, and I have noticed pregnant, which I will show you guys now because I'm going to do my belly shot. We are working on the nursery still. I got the dressing room, which I'll show you guys. If you're friends on my Instagram or Facebook, you saw the dresser that I posted there. I think I've done a vlog for. If not, I will do one next week. Only because I'm going to pick up my changing table that I found today. I'm going to top paint that one as well, so I wanted to show you when I have everything, well, not everything in there, but when I have the two big items in the room versus showing the dresser and having a camera that will show you the changing table. So right now we have a dresser and I'm going to get the changing table up. We have a little diaper caddy or like a hygiene caddy, and then we have just another little storage bin that we picked up from Walmart. The only other big items that we're waiting on is his bookshelf, his crib, and my bladder. And then that should complete the mansion. We've been picking up like the core items here and there, so I'll send those once everything comes together in the private nursery. So, yeah, let's do the belly shot. What are you doing that for? Ooh, that's doing well. So, here is the belly. Belly, belly, belly. Belly from the right side. Belly from the left side. And here is Nathaniel head on. I don't know if it's just me because of the way I'm looking at my camera or if it's through the glare. But you can kind of see the stretch marks that are right in front of my stomach. I don't scratch. I don't rub here. It's just where he likes to ball up at. And if you hadn't noticed, my line is very crooked. Goes here, then it jumps over here, and comes down all the way to the bottom. I'm guessing that's the price you pay for baby. One more thing that I have added to my regimen that I wanted to tell you guys. I'm still doing my Farmer's Cocoa Butter for stretch marks. The massage cream, and then I'm also taking vitamin E oil and I'm rubbing that right on my stomach as well to kind of help, I guess, prevent or make the stretch marks that I have not as bad. I don't have any on my sides. I don't have any anywhere else, just right in the front, and it looks like I've been clawing my stomach, and I promise you guys I haven't. What he did is just where he likes to ball up it. So that is going to be it for this pregnancy vlog. If I have forgotten anything, I'm sorry. I can get pregnant for me. If you guys have any questions, comments, or concerns, please leave them below. I do respond to comments, and I try to answer everybody who asks me anything, as well as remember to rate, like, and subscribe. Mwah.